sea of herds within and around the kingdom. The crowd.
This is Talk Time. Governors Udom, Emmanuel of Akwa Ibom and Okezie-Ikpeazu of Abia State can now get to work after the Supreme Court upheld their victories at the April 11, 2015 elections. The court will give reasons for the judgments later this month.
A sea of herds within and around the courtroom. The crowd is made up of supporters of the leading parties in both states, lawyers and top government functionaries, and the courtroom is filled to capacity. After over 14 hours of waiting and anxiety, it was jubilation galore for the ruling parties in both states. The Supreme Court confirmed the election of Governor Udom Emmanuel of Akwa Ibom State. The Apex Court also set aside the decision of the Court of Appeal over a division, which earlier nullified Ikpeazu's election and declared Alex Oti of the All Progressive Grand Alliance, ABGA, winner. The court will give reasons for the judgment in the Akwa Ibom appeal on February 15th, and while the reasons for Abia State will be given on February 26th. The hearing of the appeals had lasted for close to 10 hours while parties adopted their briefs. The court later rose at about 8 p.m. and returned at about 9:45 p.m. to deliver the judgment. While the justices led by the Chief Judge of Nigeria, Justice Mahmoud Mohammed, were in the chambers preparing the judgment, heavy security was deployed to the Apex Court. According to Justice Nweze, who read the lead judgment, said there was considerable merit in Udom's appeal. He also said the findings of the appellate and should be set aside. Counsels to both parties spoke to newsmen after the proceedings.
All witnesses to the great effort and exertion on the part of the justices of the Supreme Court. They have been busy from 8 a.m. until well past 10 p.m. So on a day like this, when you salute their courage, it's also a day for a grateful nation to express appreciation that God has blessed us with men of character, conviction and courage.
Very long and tedious journey from the tribunal to the Court of Appeal, and then finally here at the Supreme Court, and then the Supreme Court came out in a most astute manner and then restated the law exactly the way it is. So it's a thing of joy.
This is the Supreme Court of Nigeria, and that's the final judgment regarding the governorship. We really don't have a choice but to accept it in good faith.
Politicians, to accept the fate. If you have lost, you have lost. Go and prepare for the next one. So don't let us believe that we must at all times fight the battle from beginning to the end.
This judgment has finally put to rest a long-fought battle between the PDP and the APC in both states, on whose flagbearer surely won the gubernatorial elections.
Now, our focus is on the Akwa Ibom State judgment this morning. Joining me in the studio is Latif Raji, former special advisor on information and strategy to former Lagos State Governor Babatunde Rajifasola and now Minister of Power and Works. And from Abuja, I have the Attorney General of Akwa Ibom State and Commissioner for Justice, Wemdimo Nwoko. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Nwoko. And good morning to you, Mr. Raji. So let me start from you, with you in the studio. First of all, your immediate reaction to the Supreme Court ruling on the governorship election of Akwa Ibom State.
I was shocked. That was my first reaction because I strongly believe that the Court of Appeal did substantial justice to the issue raised. And I think so when I heard, I wasn't really prepared for the pronouncement. And again, after the Akwa Ibom case came the Abia State, I just saw a sort of a precedence from Rivers to Akwa Ibom now to Abia, and I keep wondering if what was really wrong, because like one of the lawyers there said in that report that men of courage, character, and all those things. I think that is what our Supreme Court should actually represent. But in these instances, I'm moved by the pronouncement of the Supreme Court, because for me it does not really follow logic. There is nothing we can really tie to this. So many things came up, and the Court of Appeal gave a lot of reasons for taking, you know, those decisions they took at that time.
All right, Mr. Nwoko, does this judgment of your of the governorship election in your state make perfect sense to you?
Yeah, it does. But let me begin appealing to my friend, your guest in Lagos studio. By the nature of my training as a lawyer of 24 years standing, I don't think that we should begin to cast aspersions on the judgment of the Supreme Court of Nigeria on the pages of newspaper. It is not a part of what should be done in a democratic society. When the Supreme Court has decided, given the fact that you had a panel of seven justices sitting together as a full court to give a decision, presided over by the Chief Justice of the Federation of Nigeria, I think that judgment deserves the highest level of appreciation. Let me add this. It is the first time in the history of Nigeria that the Supreme Court of Nigeria sat for 14 hours, spanning from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m., presided over by the aged Chief Justice of the Federation of Nigeria. It shows a great deal of commitment to state service. It shows a great deal of commitment to their call to duty. And I think that all of us should come together to appreciate these people for what they did. Nigerians owe them a great deal of debt of gratitude. Having said that, let me say that the judgment cannot but make great sense in law. Anyone who understands the legal jurisprudence of electoral processes in Nigeria would know that the judgment of the Supreme Court is founded on established principles, not only in my relation to Akwa Ibom State or the present cases that have been decided. They are based on precedents that have been set in previous cases. For example, you want to look at the judgment, even though, let me say this, the Supreme Court of Nigeria is here to give full reasons for its decision in River State, Akwa Ibom State, and Abia State. But we can see, given the arguments on both sides, the direction and the premise upon which these decisions were given. It follows earlier decisions you found in the Shinkafi case of Zamfara, the earlier decision that you found in Gombe State, the earlier decision you found in Benue and Nasarawa States. These are all principles that have been set down in many cases before now. So it's not a question that they have just taken a new decision that is newly can confound anybody. No.
All right.
Except somebody who is not involved in election petitions over the years.
Okay. Mr. Raji, just from what he said, because I was about to ask him that, but to ask you first of all, full details of the ruling is yet to be known to the public. It's going to be released on the 15th of this month. That's still days away. Now, for a panel of justices that sat for hours, many people have been saying, why wait this long before releasing the details of the ruling?
And that's why I'm surprised that the Attorney General, when he was questioning me and saying, probably casting aspersions. Well, I've not cast any aspersions. I just said I was shocked. And trying to whip up sentiments in this issue will not help. Nobody has said the Supreme Court is not. It is the final court. So whatever it is, it says, either for good or for bad, actually is binding on us. Maybe we will find time in the future to make sure that some corrections comes in. And having said that, I don't know where he's drawing his conclusions from, because this is a court that has not made this, you know, has not made it public. They've only pronounced that this is their position on this issue. They have not told us why and the reasons why they did all this. So I don't know where he's drawing all those things, all those inferences, and whipping up all those unnecessary sentiments, you know where he got all those things from. However, let me now say, yeah, it is given to the Supreme Court to make such pronouncements and later come back to say, oh, these are the reasons why we give the type of judgment we give. And again, that calls to question two issues. You find out that in the case of Akwa Ibom, a lot of House of Assembly elections were nullified. A lot of, I think the Senate too, and some of the House of Reps. In all these instances, the Supreme Court did not touch any of those. They only said, you know, give that judgment on the governorship election. And for a body that sat for so long an hour, you now start wondering to what effect if we did not have the ruling. Why did it take so long to just tell us that, oh, our position is that so person should be, you know, should retain his office? I mean, you now start wondering what happened. But you see, again, taking it a step further, this is an institution that has unsettled Nigerians to a large extent. The president came out to say, look, my problem in my fight against corruption is the judiciary. For me, is this a retaliatory pronouncement that I would dare you go out in the public to say, we are your problem? Then, since we have the power of life, you know, or death over life, or whatever it is, on these issues like this, let's tell you that we hook through here. Is that what is going on? Is this a revenge? Is this type of pronouncement, are they born out of vengeance against, or is this what Nigerians now call corruption fighting back? How do we place all this type of a thing? For instance, in Akwa Ibom, he's a lawyer. I'm not a lawyer. But again, when the appeal court was going to rule, over 600,000 votes excess were counted beyond the accredited people that.
They were saying there were collation as well.
Yeah, and collation in many places. There were violence. There were clips that showed that there were violence in all these places. One singular thing is, how come over 600,000 will vote in an election where only about 300,000 people were accredited, and our Supreme Court will still come to terms and said, yeah, this is good? So we will, you know, as Nigerians wait and as lawyers wait to get the details of that rulings, we will continue to wait. But it flies in the face to now say, you know, go ahead, Rivers, Akwa Ibom, Abia, all in quick successions. We need to re-examine ourselves. This country is bigger than the Supreme Court judges. Yeah, I agree with him. These people are the ultimate. They are the last people we can run to. But if judgment like this comes out, the average man loses confidence. You are encouraging people to take the laws into their hands. If they believe they cannot get justice from the court, it sort of results to, you know, it leads to anarchy. Mm. And that is my fear, that if we lose confidence in our judicial system, it becomes a different thing.
Okay.
Are there corruption in Nigeria? Yes, there are corruptions. Are we making any attempt to say the judiciary, yeah, and you now think the best way to go about this thing is to start, I mean, at the end of the day, it bounces back on every one of us.
All right, I'll press you further on that in a moment. Mr. Anwoko, back to you now. As a member of the bar, I'm curious, I want to know if this is a normal practice for justices of the Supreme Court, especially, to give judgment on a case and then defer release of details of such ruling to a later date.